Time to dig into another model kit on the workshop, and I know you were curious about this one, so let's get it built. It is round two models through the AMT brand 1968 Pontiac GTO hardtop. This is a new kit coming out 2023. I've done an entire unboxing of this earlier as a preview so you could get your pre-orders in, and now on film we are going to build it. So let's take a look at everything that will be in the box when you get yours. And I will also link to that much longer, more in-depth unboxing should you want to see it. So we will start looking at the plastic that's in the box. It is a curbside kit only, so you're going to see this engine plug in there that you can glue in place on the chassis. The reason they use this is so that you can also place a full engine of yourself in your choice, which is also why the hood is separate. Crisply molded, lovely. These are your axle placement parts here for the thing and for the rear axle and the front axle. They have those placers there. We've got our steering wheel. We've got our top of the hood RPM gauge, I almost said. We've got our tachometer there. We've got our wheel pins here. Those are quite delicate towards the end, so be very careful. We've got our bucket seats, a really tight looking dashboard. Very sharp, crisp, that gorgeous nose on it. Always reminds me of who was ripping who off. Was it Dodge or was it Pontiac pulling that split grill from each other? Because they did this on the 69 Chargers and then never again with those. So I thought it was kind of neat that they had a similar looking nose on them for a little while. We've got the interior tub, which is going to be, of course, one piece. Pedals are molded in with a clutch pedal on there, so we know this one is a manual. The door panels are a little shallow, but you can get some detail, and these really didn't have a ton of fancy chrome work and two-tone on them or anything. We've got our wheelbacks here, very simple and standard pieces. We've got that chassis that we just talked about, because this is a curbside and is a promo style that you can add your engine to. They mold the nice dual exhaust all the way out. I love how they got like the resonators on there and everything. Very, very nice molding. We hold it at an angle so you can see all the detail in there. I mean, it really is sharp. We've even got our brake lines. We've got our parking brake lines, suspension arms. These slots are where you'll be gluing those axle placers in. On the inside of the chassis, there's nothing really much. We've got our under hood detail on these. Of course, when I review these, I build them box stock, so I will not be adding an engine, but there are a bazillion engines available online. We've got our interior with our fan cover and our radiator support. I would not cut off that pin. I'm assuming that's used to locate the nose. Excellent work. I love that on this modern molding, they have a place for the mirror there. Door handles, panel lines, nice window molding that we can get our Sharpie or our Molotow or our bare metal foil around. GTO emblems are molded in, so if you use the decals, you just lay them over that with a little decal solvent and it looks 3D. Same as the back, we got our Pontiac Arrowhead and our GTO logo. The chrome trim along the bottom is prominent enough, it's in scale, but it's prominent enough that we could almost freehand that, I think, when we want to do that trim on there. Nice looking, and you can see inside, promo style connections, front and back. That's it for the white styrene in the box. Let's take a look at the decal sheet on this one. We've got a black pinstripe. We've also got a white pinstripe. That's a little hard to see. We can get the light to reflect against it. Then we've got our license plates, three different license plates. We got a gorgeous set of gauge decals that are doubled up for us. All kinds of Pontiac Arrowheads, logos, GTO logos, door locks, more GTO in the smaller and in white as well. We've got right here what looks like to me little tiny Ram Air decals in white. I don't see those duplicated. Oh, there they are, right there in black. Right there. So these are all mirrored right here in white for your darker paint jobs. Excellent. Fine decal sheet. Got transparent red taillight. Oh, we've got a steel axle for the rear. On this one, even though it's a promo model, two styles of wheels. stock and custom. Excellently molded and chromed, but not heavily chromed. We've got our rear view mirrors on the edge. I like how they designed these sprues now to protect the small parts like that. Then we've got our grill inserts. You'll see how I deal with that, with getting that black inside there. It's quite simple. And then our nice large rear bumper. We've got a clear parts tree, turn signals, back and front glass with side lights, the smoker's windows, nice and clear. No scratches, no defects. We've got some small parts in the box left over. We've got a set of solid. These are solid, so don't glue your wheels together. You'll never get it over. We got red line tires, black wall on the other side. I do not see a brand name molded in, and definitely a bias ply tread. What else we got going on here? We've got a nice small manual, lets you know how to do everything like it should. But of course, being a curbside, it's nice and short and sweet, like this video can be, because there's not a lot of work. So I'm going to start gluing mine together, and we'll be right back. Thank you. assembling Round 2's 1968 GTO is about as easy as it gets. If you have someone that loves the GTO, get them this kit. They don't have to have any model experience whatsoever, none needed. They can get this thing built and painted with the same kind of paints I use, and they're going to have a great time with it. So let's look at stuff before we head to paint, which won't take long at all. I've got the grills cut out. What I plan to do is paint the entire thing black. Then I will go in and accent that trim ring. I don't need to try to get in here and black wash stuff. I'll paint both sides flat black and then go in and just use my chrome pen or a Sharpie to accent that trim ring. And that's all we really need to do, as the decals will handle the rest of it for us. It shouldn't be hard at all to do that kind of detailing and make it look nice. We've got our bars for the rear suspension here. Since they're separate and since there's such large locator holes for them, I will paint them a metallic tone, and then we can accent underneath that chassis and hand paint things and work it out that way. We've got our dashboard here just separated so we can get it painted up in my preferred interior color. Got the wheel backs again. We can paint those a metallic to match the wheels. The steering wheel goes on easily. It's just a pin that fits in the back, and then it slides into the dashboard, so we can hold that, we can spray that, hand detail the spokes and whatnot like that, get it looking good. The seats will do the same way. We'll paint them the interior color, then we'll remove them and snap or glue them into place. On the interior, you can see the large locating holes for the shifter and everything. We'll get this sprayed with primer first and then accent that in our interior color. For the chassis itself, I showed you how that engine just slips in, and it's going to look great underneath there, but I will pull it out because the suspension will interfere with me getting paint on the engine block, the starter and the transmission and the exhaust pipes when I want to add those to my build. Underneath, you can see the axle locators for the rear, for the front. And then on the front, we got the wheel pins in, and I glued everything in tight so that it holds. And that's it for the chassis. Then we'll get in with our paint, and we'll accent the drive shaft, the differential. Maybe we'll do a little dry brushing to bring it out, just so you can see how nicely they can look. The body, that nose fits beautifully. I just used a little bit of glue on that pin to hold it in. That'll allow it to move a little bit when I slide the chassis in to reach those pins up there. I've already done it. I know that the nose will get pushed forward, but then when I paint it, the nose will remain the same color as the body. And because it's all in the same plane and everything, we'll be all right. The hoods, I don't worry about nearly as much getting that, because the hoods, because they're flat, always paint up just fine. We've got our optional tachometer in the hood. Of course, you could do this in an accent color as well. I've seen ones that are flat black for that tachometer. They do include two dimpled holes in the bottom of the hood that you saw me mark and then drill out to confidently attach that tachometer in the correct position. What we'll do is, after everything is painted, I will take black craft paint, dip it in there, and then clean off the outsides, and that will give it an inset look for that tachometer on there. Same as I'll do for the scoops on the Ram Air when I'm done with painting the hood and everything. So that's it. It's super easy to build. Anybody can put this thing together. I'm gonna start getting color on stuff right now. I'm back with the new 68 GTO, and I'm getting ready to wrap things up. Now, those with a keen eye are already flooding the comments during this video before we got to this part right here and going, that's not the same color you had on the car when you painted it in the paint booth, and the paint doesn't look very good on it at all. Well, yes, for some reason, and this just happens, and I'm overdue. It's been dozens of model kits for me since I've had a paint issue. I could not get my paints to lay on this body without crazing. I don't know what happened. I tried the Rust-Oleums, I tried the Krylons, I tried the Color Shot. I had to keep stripping the body. I tried Tester's enamels with tester primer. I tried Tester's lacquer with tester's primer. Didn't work. I tried Tester's enamel and lacquer without primer. Didn't work. I kept having issues. I was speaking to my buddy Gary in the UK, who sees everything in the model world. He really keeps up on everything. And he said, well, it might not be the plastic. I thought maybe it was an issue with the plastic, but he said it might not be, because there are other people that I've had preview copies, reviewers and stuff of this kit, that didn't have issues with their models. So I'm guessing we've been having a lot of really weird weather here lately. It's been going from above freezing and sunny and warm to 7 below to a blizzard. We've got a rainstorm coming with freezing rain and then snow. So the atmosphere keeps changing back and forth, and the humidity in my shop keeps changing back and forth. Even though it's winter, it's usually quite dry. I notice the pressure changes and stuff. So maybe that's the issue. What ended up working kind of sorta in quotes was Tester's Extreme Lacquer. And I didn't use a primer. I laid it down, and it was, you know, it's still kind of like crazed, but it's not as bad, and that's what I'm going to go with. So the color I ended up using on the car, just in this situation, is Extreme Lacquer Mythical Maroon. It's a metallic, and it's actually very, very attractive, and it goes good with that dull red interior. They don't contrast against each other. So that's the color I ended up doing. We saw all the work I did on the car. I've got the grill pressed in, it just friction fit, and then I put some super glue on the inside on the corners. We got those nice marker lights in. I did the chrome around there. We've got all of our trim done. I did the larger trim in Molotow. I did the window trim in a Sharpie, because that's how I like to do it. And we can still see the crazing on there, but because it's a light metallic, it kind of hides it a little bit. But if you see the reflection, that's not very pretty. I'm going to try to do multiple coats of future floor polish, and then just, you know, that's just the way it's going to be. So we've got that all set up. The model itself is perfect. There's no issues with the kit whatsoever. We did the hood. I got the trim along the back of the hood, did the vents, and did some black paint inside the hood and on the tachometer back there. So that eventually we'll just lay over the top. We won't be looking underneath the hood because there is no engine to speak of. The interior pushed into place and glued in, and that looks great in there. I did a red on red, just like the box art. I enjoyed the box art on this one. Then we did our dash detail. It's hard to tell, but I did do the wood grain like you saw me paint, and then the steering wheel, did the shifter, and glossed up the seats underneath. Since I had plenty of time, wasn't have to worrying about detailing, used a gloss blue, took about 3 coats of that over the black, then did silver, then did a Tamiya metallic for the tanks, and got our suspension, glossed up the differential, glossed up the frame rails on there, and the wheels that I chose to use with the red lines are super sweet looking. Everything on this kit has gone absolutely fine. The paint job is no fault of the manufacturing of the kit. Obviously, I'm having issues in the shop. If other people are getting paint on this without a problem, then it's got to be me. The decal set, I'll just be using the GTO emblems. Educate me in the comments. The pinstripes, I don't think go with this car. This might be from the other GTO that I've done before. They might have just reused the same decal sheet since they're similar. But I'll be putting on my logos and my Pontiac emblems. Those should go on quite easily. The dash decals went in without an issue. You saw me glue the taillights in. Those detail very nicely. How I detailed mine was, I couldn't get the silver to work around the edges without mussing up the lights themselves. So what I did was, I did the entire decal, or I did the entire light in a silver Sharpie, and then I laid in a bead of Tamiya Clear Red. And that seems to have worked. So we'll put the mirrors on. We'll put the bumper on. We got an extra set of wheels if you ever wanted to use them. Small decals. Future the heck out of it and hope that remedies some of the crazing. And I'll see you back at the final. Welcome back. This is the final of the new AMT 1968 Pontiac GTO hardtop. It is a sweet new kit. It is a curbside kit, so your build time is considerably shorter. It's got a one-piece chassis with the exhaust and differential molded in. It's got an engine plug, which means if you want to add an engine to this kit, all you would have to do is drop one in and it should mount up relatively easy, though you will need, of course, to add a 60s era GM firewall as well, but you do have the inner fenders that are molded in, and you'd also want to add a radiator support in the front if you wanted to be able to pop the hood. Or you could avoid both of those, drop in a big honking blown motor, tub out the back end, and make it a strip runner as well. So the hood does come unattached. You don't have to worry about cutting it out. The detail on the kit is awesome. My paint job on this one, due to some paint snafus during the building process, is clearly not a very, very good paint job, but it is passing to give us a review of the kit. And the review of the kit is that it is an excellent model kit. It goes together super easy. You're not going to have to fight anything. The final fits are very good. If you're not going to attach the nose, the chassis will go in much easier. If you're going to attach the nose in advance like I did, make sure you put the front of the chassis in and it will be a very, very tight fit with the interior tub on. You'll have to stretch the back fenders, snap it in place, and then push it and stretch the back fenders to get the back in. But once it's in, it goes in. You don't break anything. You don't knock the glass loose or anything like that. So it will go in, though if they I'm sure they're going to be issuing this as different versions. The next one I will try by leaving the nose off. The nose does go on so nicely and fits up so perfectly with just a little bit of factory gap it would have had that I really did not need to glue it on. I thought maybe to match the paint or get it to fit together nice, but it didn't matter at all. It's going to go on at the end and look absolutely perfect, so you could always leave that off. The rear bumper I have on there isn't even held on with any glue. It just pressed into the little pinholes that they make for it just below the trunk, and it just fits. It just goes on. The final decals went on very easily. We just have the GTO logo on the grill, the GTO logo, and the Pontiac arrowheads, and the arrowhead for the front of the nose. You can see the GTO emblem on the grill as it goes by there, kind of hidden in there. No problems at all. And I love my wheel choice. I know a ton of them had the mag wheels, and it's extremely common, but I wanted to go with more of a plain wheel. This has no cool striping. It's just a red on red GTO for someone that wanted a sporty, fun car to drive around in. The mirror goes on easy with that pre-drilled hole. You could always drill a hole on the other side, mount the passenger side mirror on. Really depends on what you wanted to do. The trim work is easy to do because the mold is in perfect shape and everything is lovely. So can't wait for you guys to start getting a hold of these things. It's going to be a lot of fun. Can't wait to see a lot of better paint jobs than mine due to the paint snafus I had, but the couple coats of future floor polish did help it quite a bit, but it's still, you could see that crazing underneath it, and that's just the way it goes. If you have more time, of course, you would keep working on it and bring that down and repaint it and work it over. But just to get the review done, I wanted you to see how the kit went together, and it goes together absolutely beautifully. The red line tires, the wheel set, you have those optional wheels. It's just a fantastic kit. The taillights just snap into place and are held in with a little bit of super glue when I did them. The glass pretty much snaps in tight like you saw in the video. And then I just did some Mod Podge around the sides just to make sure when I stretched the body on it didn't pop loose on me. The dashboard is beautiful, has the full gauge cluster on there with the decals. I really enjoyed it. Can't wait to see what else they do with it. We will see all of you at the next review.